Hello guys, welcome back to Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. So, last time I left off, we made it to Steven's story, and we finished off Lizzie's story, which is pretty cool. And I actually had to replay a couple sections back because the game didn't save. So, not too much difficulty, technical difficulties. I had about a five minute backtrack. Had to watch that scene in the main hall and then walk the path up here. And you walk pretty slowly, so holy crap, that thing's quick. So we're up to Steven's part.
It's completely dead. It won't start.
It's only a short walk to the camp. I think we should split up. You go and fetch Rachel. I'll go back to the village and find Evie.
I don't think we should split up.
I don't want to either, Charlie, but we've got to. I'll meet you back at my house later on, okay? We can talk properly then.
Why won't you tell me what happened?
No, actually, you should stay at the camp tonight. Come and find me in the morning. Bring Rachel back. She's going to need her mother.
Meg.
Just take care of her.
Meg!
What is it, Charlie?
Why are you dodging his questions?
Just be careful, that's all.
I will, I promise. You as well. See you later on.
Is it me or is, like, Steven's orb so active? Holy crap. Alright, Steven. We're gonna figure out... Why is the sky so red? I guess time is actually going. Because I assume time stopped at 6:07. Alright, where are we? We are here, Little Tipworth. Okay. So, I think this is the final area. We made it through Valis Observatory. We made it through Yawton. Tipworth Forest was Wendy. Appleton Farm was Frank. Lakeside was Lizzie. Yawton was Jeremy. Now we have Steven, Lil Tipworth. And I think they said there was one more person. I'm pretty sure it's Kate. That's the final piece of the puzzle here. So, wait, let me see this map. Is this a circular area? There's a phone booth, there's a train station, there's a couple paths that lead off. Oh, there's that little building behind the Appleton Farm I need to go to. I remember that. Yeah. If anyone remembers, behind the farm there was a gate that was blocking it. I want to go there. There was a distress signal or a radio. Oh. So this part of the town is not even finished being built. Alright, man. Is there something here you want me to see? Oh, phone call? Phone call? It's behind there. Oh, you can go this way. Forleys. Builder Merchants. Oh, he's infected.
Kate said about patterns. I can't grasp it clearly yet.
Okay, come over. Have some lunch. We can talk properly. Have you spoken with Kate?
Well, she's locked herself in the observatory. She's buried in the data. But it's already out here in the world. I need to see how it adapts.
How what adapts? Stephen, try to explain.
Oh, shit. I still don't know what it is. I haven't got a grasp of what it is. Like, what is the rapture? What is it? Like, scientifically speaking, what is it? I don't know. It causes hemorrhaging, headaches, and nosebleeds. Why do I feel like I have it? I have all that but hemorrhaging. Jesus. Can I go back here? I kind of hope I'm going to beat the game today. I'm going to keep playing until I actually beat it. Because I want to figure out what the hell is going on in this damn town. Like, seriously. Some crazy shit's going on. And I don't trust any of it. Okay, let's go through here. See if I can go. Can I go inside the house? This doesn't. Oh, it's open. Oh, there's a light in here if I've ever seen one.
Do you think she'll like it?
It's in an awful state, Stephen. I don't think
so. It'll be an adventure. It'll mean putting down roots here, maybe a family.
Are you sure she wants children? What, to stay here? It's not her place, you know.
Don't stop it again, please.
I mean, she's ambitious, love, and she's, well, older. She's not going to want to stay cooped up at home looking after the kids.
Is that how you felt about me?
Oh, stop it, Stephen. That's not what I meant, and you know it. I'm just saying you should make a choice. If it's a family you want, well, you know how much Lizzie wants a family.
Jesus, Mum, I didn't come here for marriage guidance. So that's what you thought about a fucking house.
Stephen, Appleton language.
Sorry, it's just that you have to understand, Kate is the most brilliant, extraordinary, wonderful person I've ever known. She's like no one else. The way she looks at things, it's like she has whole worlds inside her head. I don't think you or anyone really understands that.
Like how the mom was like, it's so simple, just hook up with Lizzie again. She wants a family. Like, she's crazy. You can't just do that. So this was the unfinished home that Steven and Kate were going to buy, I assume. Or I guess Steven bought, and he didn't tell Kate. Saving. Yes. I got a checkpoint. What a wonderful world. We have checkpoints in this game, guys. This place actually looks pretty good. Minus the creepy walking. Why is there red paint here? Who likes red paint? Yeah, this is a nice house, other than the fact that I hear footsteps that are not mine. So, you might want to look into that, Steven. This place might be haunted. Can I go in here? Oh shit, I can. I hear a ringing. Anyone hear that? Like a phone call? I heard a phone call. Where did I hear that from? I don't know. I heard a phone call. So weird. Okay. I'm pretty sure I heard a phone ring. It came from like the left side. But I went all over the left side. Shoot, I don't know. Alright, well, let's continue. So this is a pretty big house. They have a big front yard. It's pretty impressive. What you can buy. I wonder how much it costs too. Oh, it was probably this radio station.
Physical changes are evident. Although the butterfly burn is now faded, I can clearly see the change in my pores up close.
Okay, so there's a butterfly.
As I record these words, I can feel myself hearing them as for the first time, as if I'm both speaker and listener simultaneously. I am a scientist. I can only deal with the evidence I have. And this points in one simple direction. It's not in the observatory. It's in me.
Ooh. Ooh. I wonder if that's how Steven got it. He slept with Kate. You know, that is his wife. And they bumped uglies. And she slapped him across the face. I don't know. So they are butterflies. Good to know. Is that the whisker? I've been hearing about that. Yeah, public house. Yeah. Yeah. Remember, if you remember from when we visit the pub in Yachton, they said, hey, head to the whisker. This place is closed for business. This is far, if you think about it. Like, the pub is in the first town. You had to go through the forest. Then you had to go through the farm. Then you got to go up to Little Tipworth. Actually, to be honest, that's probably not far if you have a car. Yeah, never mind. I guess it's just far because we walk there. So. Okay, I can't go here. Can I? I want to go there. It's so dark, it's hard to see. Oh, phone call. Is it for me? Did I go here yet? Can I go here? No, I can't. Man, don't be sorry. You're not the only one. I'm starting to think. For a second, I kind of thought Steven was alive still. But then that's his like orb of light right there. So there's kind of no way that's possible. I mean, if you've been taken by the Rapture, I'm assuming that you are an orb of light at this point. We haven't seen Kate. Kate's orbital light. Maybe she is the frickin' Rapture. Whatever it is. Alright, so let's check that building over there. We'll check the pub after. I want to go this way because that's where Steven went. And Steven's orb is so active. Like, it's so active. I wonder if that has to do something with personalities. Like, he's kind of hot-headed. Lizzie was kind of caring and whatnot. Oh, it's coming from inside. Inside the house?
No phones, you know the protocol. That doesn't matter now. It's figured out how to circumvent the telecommunications blackout.
What?
I didn't think it could. Kate understood. She saw how adaptable it was. How smart.
Jesus Christ, you're talking about it like it's alive.
You have to assume that everyone here is infected.
We can't know
that. We are infected. It's killed all the birds, and now it's in us. It's trying to leave the valley any way it can. The quarantine is not enough. You've got to remove the carriers. You've got to cut off its energy source, its food.
I've already told you, Stephen, I'm not going
to
water an airstrike.
Now it knows we're onto it, it's going to keep on spreading as fast as it can.
The quarantine and blackout will hold it in check. They've cut all of the phones out of the valley, so it's only you communicating out now.
Aren't you listening? It's figured out ways around it. Radio waves, something. All of the lines are cut, but the phones are working anyway. You've done all the right things, but it's not enough. You've got to stop it before it adapts again.
Stephen, my family... My wife and kids.
You know perfectly well what you've got to do.
I can't do it. Don't ask me to do it.
Oh.
You're asking me to sign their death warrant. My own family.
Damn it, don't you think I'm aware of that? I'll still be here when you drop the fucking stuff. Don't you lecture me about sacrifice, you spineless little shit. If you're so full of ideas, you come here and try dealing with it. Tell them. The time when we had a choice is over. Tell them to do it. You've got to do it now.
So that was the phone call that Frank was listening. Was it Frank? I think it was Frank. He overheard Steven and Clive on the radio. And you kind of got you kind of got like a garbled. He got the garbled communication of it, where you only heard Steven like sounding like a dick. But Steven's trying to make things right. Can you blame him? Kate's a fucking... She's crazy. For trying to continue this. Trying to continue. I'm guessing Clive works for, like, the Air Force or something, or the military, or, like, the CDC or something. I don't even know. People who deals with who deal with disease and stuff. It's probably the CDC. And obviously his family is living here, and that's why he doesn't want to call the airstrike. So, makes sense. Alright, I want to check the garden back here. Oh, there's nothing back here. I don't know. Oh, wait, does this let me go to this house? Oh, it's just connected. Oh, I can't go to this one. Okay. Alright. Now, there's a little pathway back here. From the house. I don't know if I should go down this place. Because that leads to another area. Alright, so let's go to the pub. Let's go to the pub first. Because there might be a clue in there, and then we'll go towards the back path. Because everyone said, go to the whisker. Oh, does that say public footpath? Yeah, sorry, so we do have to follow that. So we are there. Oh, I think that back route actually goes to that little farm place behind the farm, the building behind the farm. So let's go to the pub, and then maybe we should just continue, because then that path leads there. We'll see. I'm going to just backtrack a little. I said to the pub. Ooh, they have a basement. Can we go in? Oh. Is the pub open? This the seventh Whiskers? Seventh Whistler. Excuse me, that was Whisker. Nothing back here. What the hell? What kind of noise you making, bro? Oh, it's open. Hello? Pub quiz. Korean pint, that's a weird combination. Local fish and chips.
You look well.
I don't. But thank you. You do. How are you settling in?
Nothing changes around here. I mean, it's great to be back. It still feels like home, I suppose. In a funny kind of way.
It's been a long time, Stephen. Last time you saw me, I could still walk properly.
You look pretty good to me.
Stop it.
For what it's worth, I'm sorry about how things worked out.
Or didn't,
right.
Do you think you made a mistake leaving?
My mum tells me it's never too late to change things, to put things right.
Funny. It's just what she said to me the other day. I have been wondering what she meant by that.
That's embarrassing. Sorry.
Maybe I should go.
Why?
Stephen, we're both married. I don't think this is a good idea.
What isn't? We're just two old friends having a drink, that's all.
Mm-hmm, that's how it starts. That's how it starts. why is there a thing here? Yachtin and Tipworth Stargazer Club. Contact Graham at the Valis Observatory or drop by the village. It's a Sunday at 8. Young, old, amateur, pros for everyone. They're very into the stars and whatnot here. Oh god. I don't want to walk over that just because I get locked in. Okay. Locked. Okay. So we'll take that back path behind the house, see where it goes. It probably just leads to another area, to be honest. In the same place. Yeah, that path right there. The public footpath. Let's hope I don't get murdered. There's no one else here, though. You never know. Why is there a quiet town in the middle of nowhere? And all the people are missing. Alright, does this lead behind the farm? I don't even know where I am. Haverton. It's getting dark and gloomy in this game. Ah, I think this is behind the farm. Yeah, yeah. This was the gate, right? Yep. And now it's open. I can head back to the farm if I want to.
It's all over the valley. Don't you get that? This isn't some abstract thing. Whatever came down into the tower has got out. They've quarantined the whole valley.
It's right here in the observatory.
It's out in the world. It's adapting and spreading. Do you understand?
No, we can't turn it away. It's come too far.
Okay, people are disappearing. Shut it down now.
No. If you won't help me, I'll do it on my own. I'm gonna route all the power back through Tower 6.
Kate!
Wait, wait. Oh, it's trying to break through again.
Okay. Wait.
Wow. That's how you know Kate's a bitch. She cares nothing for the people that live here. Are you serious? I would have slept with Lizzie too. Oh, fuck that. Never mind. I was trying to be all like sentimental back then. No. No. Frickin' Kate. She cares nothing for the people here. That's probably why she chose to stay here. She has no like connection to these people, and Steven does because he's lived here as a child and probably grew up here with Lizzie being his wife. But Kate has no connection to this town other than her working here and moving in with Lizzie or Steven for whatever reason.
You were getting into.
Really?
Well, I'm sorry we don't measure up to your exacting standards, Dr. Collins. Maybe you just need to give us ordinary humans a break.
What?
Ooh.
Ordinary humans like Lizzie Graves?
Ooh.
Really think that I wouldn't find out?
Oh shit.
Frank told me. Or did you forget there's one person in this shithole who actually talks to me?
Kate, oh. It was just a dream.
Don't bother, Steven!
Oh, for Christ's sake. Kate, slow down.
You were engaged to her, Stephen. You nearly married her.
Oh, come on. It was just a drink.
Then why the hell did you lie to me about
it? Because I knew you'd be mad and then it would end up in a row. You wanted to focus on the event tonight.
Oh, so you were actually doing me a favor. Wow, I guess I just forgot to say thank you. Do not treat me like I'm an idiot.
You're overreacting. I know you're stressed.
Just don't.
Also, they weren't married. They were just engaged.
I'm not gonna let you ruin this for me.
Oh, shit.
Kate, come on, this is crazy.
Oh, shit. I thought they were actually married. Oh, my God. I actually thought they got married. Right, I'm gonna head back because there's a path over here. So they weren't, they were never married? Oh, my Lord. So is Kate his first wife? The fuck? What happened? How can you love someone enough to be engaged but not even marry them? I can understand if he had cold feet or something, but to break up an engagement and then not even and then marry another chick? What the hell is wrong with you, Steven? Jesus. Influenza. Was that the only way there? Into the thing? I can probably make a left. Station approach. Oh, it's a train station. Road closed. It doesn't seem like a lot of people lived here. Hell's that noise?
I've not seen it.
They do, though.
You're overreacting.
Steven, they stare at me. Yesterday, I went into the village, and this old woman just stopped in the middle of the street
and stared at me like I had two heads.
Oh, don't be so melodramatic.
I'm like a walking freak show. Oh, this place, it's so insular. I just don't understand how you grew up here.
Well, I was very different then. And they're not so bad, really.
That's easy for you to say.
Just give it a bloody chance, Kate. This was the deal. A year here, and we could be in with a real shot at Lacia.
Stephen!
Lacia?
Oh, Christ, it's Lantham.
Stephen Appleton, I thought it was you. What's all this about a young wife? Oh. Hello.
Two heads, Stephen. Hi, I'm Kate.
Oh, man. Okay, I don't think there's anything else down here. Who the hell's Lacia? Sounds oddly disturbing. Anything else in here? No? Can I walk? I can. Holy shit. I was going to cross the bridge over there, but. Hell yeah, I'll walk on the train tracks. Alright, let's see. This is a train station? Can I go inside? Oh, it's open. Oh, there's a thing in here. It's left. Oh, it's the end. Oh, that's the end of Stevens. No, I don't want to do it yet. I don't want to do it yet. Not yet. Not yet. You notice how it's the biggest... It's a big ball of light. I want to... Oh, no, 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 not yet, not yet, not yet. Not just yet. Not just yet. We'll come back, Steven. Yeah, that one was a bigger ball of light, so that means that's the finale for Steven's thing, I assume. So you can get the finale without even, like, getting all the stuff? I'm pretty sure there's more, because there's the station on the left and all that. So we'll come back. I'm sorry, Steven. I'll come back, bro. Don't worry. I still want to figure out everything that's here. Alright, let's do it quickly. There's still a cable line here. It's weird how it would be so early, though. Like, up there. Huh. Can I even go this way? I don't want to finish his part of the story yet. It seems pretty early. Yeah, I couldn't go here before. Oh, radio.
Pressure in my eyes again. I can't move my legs, can't feel my face. When I collapsed, the light was waiting for me there. Caught me, lowered me here. Now it's pooling around my feet, watching me. The printers are spewing out page after page of zeros. It's frightened, too. It'll be okay. It'll be fine.
What the f-
I'll look after you. It's alone. It's scared. Oh, it's traveled so far.
What the f-
It's okay. I can help you. We can be together now. 10 seconds to signal fusion. We can be together. 3 seconds. 2.
Ew. She got taken over. Ah, look at that. There's still more. Ah, the train station's the last one. There's two more here? One more? There's one. Oh, there's one all the way to the left. Where am I? Is that me? All the way to the left? Like, that might be me. What was that noise? Steven, you in there? Didn't he say he was at the substation? What was that humming? You hear the humming? Is that the Rapture? Is that whatever's here? No, can't go in there. So maybe I am done. That was quick, though. Huh. I feel like there's more left, though, still. So I can't go... I don't think I can go in here. No. No. Okay. It's locked. Alright. We shall continue. So I think the train station is the last place we have to go. What is down here? I think that leads to the path to where we came from. So we would have came full circle anyways. And this is a gas station. There's a fence here. Let's go to the gas station and then we'll finish off Steven's story. See what's going on. It's getting really dark. So I'm guessing we're heading to the event. Oh my god.
They closed the tunnel.
There's no trains. Put up a sign.
The tunnel, Howard. Is it closed?
I think so. I don't like it. It's not right at all.
Stop whining. It doesn't help anyone. Did you know you're bleeding?
Oh, it's this headache. It's just killing me. I haven't had a nosebleed like this since I was a kid.
But you've not been to the village?
No, I've been here the last couple of days or at home. I've only spoken to Clive at the EMC on the phone. Well, tried to anyway, but with all the crossed lines...
But no direct contact with any other people?
No, no one. What are you talking about? What's going on?
It's the pattern. It's adapted again. It doesn't need direct contact to transfer. It's using the phones.
What do you mean, direct contact? Steven!
Holy shit. Alright, I feel like we're getting ahead of ourselves here, but I'm gonna check these last two. I'll check this and I'll go back.
This is Catherine Collins, recording for posterity. It's all over. I don't know how long I've got. Whatever he did, whatever the planes were carrying, it's burning my lungs.
Oh, shit.
Probably some kind of nerve agent. I suspect it's only exposure to the pattern that has kept me alive this long.
So it's called the pattern.
I'm making my way to Tower 6. I'm going to fuse the signals from the optical array. I just hope I can make it.
Okay. Yeah, I'll go back to this, to the, There's so many things here.
Hello? Hello, is there anyone there? Can anyone hear me? Clive, it's Stephen Appleton. Are you there? Can you hear me? Over. Come on, Clive, where are you? Damn it. Kate, it's Stephen. Come in Tower 6. Kate, are you there? Kate? Anyone? Hello? Can anyone hear me? This is Dr. Stephen Appleton broadcasting from within the quarantine zone. Can anybody hear me? Oh.
Nope.
Oh, God. No. Fucking hell, no!
Goodbye, Stephen. Soup of the day. I don't know how to say that. Bullet. Moligatawani? Moligatani. Okay. Never heard of that. Alright. I think maybe this is the end, like, of this area. Because I can go, I'm here. And the train station's to my right. So let's go check out the last thing to our left there. That thing right there. And then we'll go to the train station. What does it say? Valley Farms, agricultural cellars. Okay. I haven't been. Where did this go?
Jesus, man, what are you doing to your face?
I knew it.
You collecting feed? Looks like the supplies haven't been coming in.
Again?
Phones are all strange. I can't pinpoint the logic of transmission.
You what? What are you doing with that paint?
Means the EMC are actually moving at the proper speed. Listen, Frank. Have you heard anything on the radio about a flu outbreak?
Doesn't seem much like flu to me.
They're shutting down access to the valley to try and isolate it. No. Something about the phones. I can't put my finger on it quite yet.
What are you talking about? Hey, I'm still talking to you. Where are you going?
I knew there was something here once I saw that bench. Okay, so this leads to the path. Yeah, it leads to the back behind the Appleton Farms thing. All right, so let's check that that one warehouse, and then we'll finish up Steven's story. I'm excited. Ooh, that's all these dead birds though. Ugh. And maybe we'll get a freaking semblance of what the hell is going on here. Seriously, this place is horrible. Valley Farm Wholesalers. Yeah, because the train station's up there. All right, so let's check this last place. This is the last major area on this part of the what is this place called? Little Tipworth. Was there something up here? I forgot the butterfly map.
You're a daft old bird walking all the way out here for it. You know Charlie would have dropped it off.
What, and have that stinking great lorry of his poisoning my birds? He shouldn't be driving it on these lanes. It's a hazard.
I think he was hoping he could have a word with you about Frank.
There's nothing to say.
Oh, listen, Wendy, they might all be scared of you, but that's not going to work with me. You're 68 years old. Grow up. Talk to Frank.
How dare you speak to me like that? Give me my bird feeder right now.
Promise me you'll drop by and see your brother.
Megan Holloway, give
me... Not a chance. Promise me. It's for your own good, and you know it.
You are a shamelessly manipulative and difficult woman. It's no wonder Charlie adores you so much.
No wonder you never finish what you start. I thought I told you to check the incoming stock orders. Wendy, one bird feeder for you. I'll tell Frank you'll stop by. Charlie, stop mooning around and stick the kettle on. Make yourself useful.
So Frank is Wendy's brother? I didn't know that. Okay. Weird. Why is Wendy so old and bitter? She seems like a nice lady. She's trying to get Lizzie and Steven back together. Because Steven and Kate don't seem like they mesh too well. Other than them being doctors. But like, she is so bitter. Alright, is there anything else over here? I see a light in here. There it is.
Appleton!
What are you doing here?
You thieving bastard. I knew it was you.
Listen, take everything you need. But then you have to leave.
You don't understand. You can't be near me. Painting these stupid little pictures. Stealing food. You always were a little prick.
Please, every second we're in proximity makes it worse. I'm a primary conduit.
You're a fucking disgrace. Come here!
Sam,
don't touch me! Get off!
What's going on?
Come in here!
Jesus,
get over
Sam!
Us. Thinking you're so much better than the rest of us.
No physical
you
contact!
You and your stupid fucking missus!
Sam, stop
She's
it.
Better than any of you!
Oh, shit. Oh my god, did he kill him?
Meg, please.
Don't come near me.
Meg!
Charlie!
Meg, wait!
Don't touch me.
Please, you have to understand, it was an accident.
Get off her!
Let go, let's just go.
Charlie, you have to understand, it was an accident.
Let's just leave him. Leave him!
What have you done, Appleton, you bastard?
Come on, Charlie, let's
Meg,
just get
Charlie,
out of here!
Please!
Oh shit, he killed Sam. With a freaking hammer! Oh my god. Steven, you're a dick. You're a murderer now. What the f- Oh my god. He's a murderer. Well, he just murdered the whole damn village with whatever the hell him and Kate were doing. Oh my god. I'm glad I came to see this. This game, like, you feel for a character 1 minute and then the next you just hate them. You hate their guts. Like, in the beginning I thought Kate was cool. Like, she was a doctor, they were researching something. I thought she wanted to make things right, and then the more you go through the story, you just realize, hell no. She has no care whatsoever for the people living here. And then Lizzie and Steven were engaged. They're both married now, and they were sleeping together. That's just fucked up. And then Wendy's old and bitter, but she loves her son. So, everyone here is basically human! if you think about it. That's what makes you human, right? Being able to respect someone 1 minute and hate them the next. Alright, let's finish up Steven's story.
Darling Steven.
Oh, this is Lizzie going to...
Okay. Ever listen to this.
Yeah.
Maybe you've decided to stay with Kate, and I can't blame you for that.
Yeah, Lizzie's at the train station waiting for Steven.
I've got to think about the baby.
The baby?
Well, I should have left a long time ago. I've run out of excuses for not leaving now. But I do love you, Steven.
Wow.
And I hope you find peace one way or another.
So Lizzie is pregnant with Steven's son? Daughter?
This plane's coming.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh my god. Oh my god, that sucks. She never left. Oh my god, Steven, what the fuck did you do? Oh my god. Wow, dude. She was pregnant with your child. Oh my god. That's horrible. That's horrible. I'm sad now. Wow. She was pregnant with his child. She was waiting for the train station to come. The train to come. And she basically died in the bombing. Wow. That sucks. So that wasn't the end of Steven? I guess that was just a really big turning point. I guess we keep going.
Repeating over and over to myself in the dark, eating cold food from a can with my fingers. My name is Catherine Collins. I am Catherine Collins. As if I can force the world to acknowledge my existence. Time has ceased to exist in any real terms. I'm reduced to marking out the days on the walls. Like a cavewoman.
Hmm. Where haven't we gone? This place is cut off. Where else do we go, Steven? Where do we go? Where do we go? I'm following you, man. This way?
Services, and we're also going to be shutting down the roads for a bit. You're going to be dealing with some anxious people, Howard, so you need to explain it's all under control, and we'll be back to normal in a few days. All right? Open up the emergency store. There's posters and boards, along with a bunch of stuff that hasn't been used since the war. Grab anything you think might be useful. I need you to close up any unoccupied buildings, put posters up, that sort of thing. Make sure everything is all squared away and shipshape. You are a military man, I'm sure you understand that. Everyone doing their bit, following their orders. All right? All right? I think. Good man. I knew we could count on you.
Oh, shit.
Jesus, please. What the hell was that?
That's how you got infected, bro. Jesus Christ. So where else do we go? It's a dead-end town. Is Steven gonna show me something? Whoa. It's like model. It's a train model. That's pretty cool. There's binoculars here. Oh, maybe Steven's waiting for me. Oh yeah, 607? Yep, 607. Never forget. Alright. Maybe we have to follow Steven now. I got some heavy legs. Can't go down the stairs. Anything else back here? No, locked. Steven, I'm following you, man. Where else do we go? Show me the way. Oh, maybe we have to follow the light? Do we follow the light? That's what Kate said to do, right? Steven, where are we going? Look at that. They're like traveling through the wires. I think that's what we have to do. We have to follow it. I don't think we go that way, do we? It's not traveling that way. It's traveling this way. And I think that was a dead end. Oh, do we go to... Oh, we come to here now. Holy shit, what is happening? Steven, you want to explain this? Oh, is that gate open now? Oh, God. Oh, it's open. Oh, shit. Alright, guys, we're going to end it here. Because we're coming up on 50 minutes. And Steven, no! Steven, wait for me! You have to hold my hand or you get lost. Oh, you suck. Alright, guys, I will see you guys in the next part. We're going to go into this bunker and see what the hell is going on with this town. I'll see you guys then.